Well, you know, we have a really cool event that people can start going to at the Sheldon. I know we're kind of standing here in the dark, but we do have this really cool light box here, more than a light box. We have Evan and Stacy Smith. They are the artists behind Liminal Spaces. We're going to start with Chris Pyman, Marketing and Publicity Director for the Sheldon Concert Hall and Art Galleries. You guys are always working to push the envelope here. Tell me, what is it about Liminal Spaces that you thought would be great for the Sheldon?
Well, for one thing, as you already mentioned, it's in the dark, which is so cool. It's just such an immersive experience when you walk in the galleries and the lights are all off, but then you see these beautiful light boxes. This is just one example, but there's just so many colors and shapes and just like kind of ambiances that these guys have created with their artwork. It's really neat, and it's very different from what we've done in the past, and it's such a cool use, I think, of technology and art and bringing those together.
Now, I do have to apologize to Evan here. I touched the art, which you're not supposed to do at an exhibit. I am so sorry. But Evan, I have to see, I mean, it's changing colors in there.
Yeah. So it's got a slow fade over about a minute of time. So it does a red to yellow. Uh-huh. And so the idea is that when people see it for the first time, it might be one color. And then if they decide to come back, they'll have like a different experience. So.
Well, I mean, it's more than just light, right, Stacy Smith? I mean, because also I see something that looks a little bit like a labyrinth to me, just a little bit without the stairs. Can you tell me about what else do you guys frame the light with?
Sure. So each of these sculptures is kind of mimicking a different architectural space, and the word liminal means kind of a between space, a space that can take you somewhere. So on the surface, these are really cool to look at, but then also there's kind of they offer kind of a deeper draw you in, a longing to be further in and see what's going on down in there and in any of the other sculptures.
And Chris, about that whole drawing in, I mean, it seems almost like a meditative effort whenever you're looking at this. Can you tell me about that?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we love to get people close to the sculptures, and even when you're mentioning like touching them,
we kind of
a little bit encourage that they're built for that.
Okay.
But we're also talking about kind of in the language, visual language, we're hoping for some sort of like longing to be able to get into that space too. So the reason they're not big and immersive,
right.
The reason that they're small, so we're hoping that there's some sort of kind of play with the not able to get there or whatever.
You know, I'm gonna act like I'm deep here. So Stacy, I have to ask, I do notice on Instagram, because I absolutely love watching architecture on Instagram, I noticed that there is this kind of the splitting of the space between really, really big structures mm-hmm. and really small ones like these. Can you tell me a little bit about trying to go small but still mimicking like maybe a huge avant-garde building or something like that?
Yeah, so, and I think the low lights help with that too. These big buildings offer these meditative spaces, whether it's an art space or a religious space. And you can have these experiences, and some people have them and some people don't. And so the size of this is kind of mimicking that accessibility to the transcendent, either through religion of any description or through art, a specific art piece.
Chris, did you know all this when you curated this?
Well, luckily I did not have to curate this. Our wonderful gallery director, Olivia, brought these guys to us, and I just was so fascinated to learn more about it. And like you, I love architecture, and I love the combination that they do with the art and the architecture. They're exhibiting in our architecture gallery, which is one of the few, if only, architecture art spaces in St. Louis. So that's something we're really proud of, and it's such a cool thing to be able to bring those together.
Sounds like the place I need to be. Ladies and gentlemen, we have Liminal Spaces showing at the Sheldon Art Gallery and Concert Hall. That's at 3648 Washington Boulevard in Grand Center. That will go through April 13th. Just visit thesheldon.org. You never know what you might find in the in-between here on the 9 a.m. show.